Help me out here, Kosha. Black Friday, it all centres around Thanksgiving. Now, we don't have Thanksgiving in Australia. So why we seem to have adopted Black Friday in the last couple of years?
You know, it's interesting, and as somebody who's relatively new to Australia, it struck me as well, because there's no bearing in the culture for the Thanksgiving aspect of it, but it's just another event by the retail industry to sort of, you know, push sales on that thing and have a marquee event that deep discounts and all sorts of strategies, marketing strategies are surrounded. And, you know, it makes sense, I guess, other countries looking at it, that here's something we can pick off from the U.S. and sort of push that consumerist mindset and this concept of big sales. I think there's been some interesting pushback from local businesses against that over here. And it's interesting because, you know, big box retailers and big e-commerce companies like Amazon really have, for the past decade or so now since they launched and came on the map, have really benefited from a lot of structural advantages. And it's increasingly becoming difficult for small mom and pops and small businesses to compete about them. That has only been expanded and amplified in the pandemic, yet another casualty of the pandemic, in addition to what you just talked about in the previous topic. And I think, you know, that's why there's some pushback against Black Friday that different retailers are trying to pursue. And, you know, we'll see if they can shift that and move the needle in that. But I think it's going to be difficult because it's just become this big event all around the world.
Yeah, Black Friday and Halloween, we seem to be grabbing them, and then we're getting all worried about Australia Day. I think we've got our priorities wrong.